Hello, in this video, I'm going to be talking about the red devil. What is it? What is it used for? Why do we call it that? And what should you look out for? Before I go on, I'd love to invite you to subscribe to our channel. We're always putting out new content, usually now, based on questions and suggestions that you have. I'd also love to invite you to go to yerbba.com to get your personalized report, and you can see if this medication will be part of your treatment plan. So what is the red devil? The red devil is a term used in public circles to describe the anthracycline called doxorubicin, the brand name of which is adriamycin. This is a really powerful drug in treating not only breast cancer, but lymphoma, and it was one of the earliest anti-cancer drugs. This drug alone has saved more lives than many other cancer treatments. Why is it called the red devil? Well, its chemical structure makes it appear red. The way it refracts light makes it look red. It's a clear red. It's not thick like soup. It's clear like jello, liquid jello. It's also, so that's the red part. The devil is because it's a pretty strong chemotherapy, and anything that's really strong against cancer also tends to have a lot of side effects. Usually physicians don't refer to their treatments as the red devil, but when we're asking somebody what chemotherapy we got in the past, we might ask them if they received a red chemotherapy drug, and that's what we're talking about. We don't use the term because we don't want to invoke fear in people. Now, if you've gone through treatment and you've heard this term, you probably know why we call it that, and it can be a shorter way of saying an anthracycline or a doxorubicin. The way the drug works is by interfering with DNA and the ability of DNA to replicate. Cancer cells divide because they can reproduce their DNA and then divide and make two cells out of one, and then more cells out of, so four out of those two, and just increasing and increasing. And if we can block the DNA from replicating itself, the cancer cells can't divide. If they can't divide, they can't grow and they can't cause problems. Usually anthracyclines are given with another drug. They might be given, for example, with cyclophosphamide or Cytoxan, and that regimen is called AC. So we take the first letter of adriamycin and the first letter of cyclophosphamide, and that makes AC. It can also be given on its own, either with other drugs to follow or precede it, or it can be given on its own in somebody with advanced disease. It can be given as often as weekly or as infrequently as every 3 weeks. If we're using it in the adjuvant or curative setting, where we're giving it before surgery or after surgery, we usually give it every 2 to 3 weeks. In advanced disease, we tend to give it weekly and then follow that with a break. So we might go 3 weeks in a row and then give somebody some time off and then start the cycle over again. It's given in a syringe. It's a pretty big syringe, and it might even be two syringes. Doesn't hang in a bag, and it's not given by mouth. It's given through your vein using a syringe.
Diagnosed with breast cancer? Meet Yerbba, your guide to personalized treatment options. Each option is specifically tailored to the unique characteristics of your tumor. Sign up today at yerbba.com to take control of your breast cancer journey.
Common side effects of doxorubicin, or the red devil, are lowering of the white cell counts, sometimes anemia, lowering of the red cell counts after quite a few cycles, or if you're already anemic. It can cause hair loss, especially in combination with other drugs like cyclophosphamide. Along with cyclophosphamide, it can cause mouth sores and nausea. We're pretty good at preventing vomiting, but it can cause vomiting, especially the two drugs combined together. On its own, the nausea risk is actually lower, but when we give two drugs together that cause nausea, it increases the risk. So you should be getting, if you're on AC, the best anti-nausea medications, even if they make you sleepy, to keep you from getting sick, especially the first cycle. Other things to know about the anthracyclines is that over time, cumulatively, they can cause problems to the heart through the same mechanism that kills cancer cells. We think that the reason they cause heart problems is through generation of free radicals, and those free radicals can affect the heart, especially after somebody's had a certain dose. So not usually 4 cycles of AC, but indefinite cycles, we would be monitoring somebody's heart function or we'd stop the drug altogether. And there's also a medication that can be given before the doxorubicin with each treatment that help protect the heart. This is given very often in children because their risk is higher that they'll need another anthracycline later in life. Anybody getting radiation to the heart and an anthracycline, like kids with tumors in the middle of the chest, will be monitored very closely and will get this cardioprotective medication. And if somebody's getting just 4 cycles of doxorubicin, they're well below the threshold at which we see heart problems. So we don't monitor the heart during treatment unless somebody gets symptoms. Symptoms of heart problems are shortness of breath, chest pain, but mostly things to do with your respiratory system. You're not getting enough blood to the lungs and to the rest of the body because the heart pump is not working as well. The anthracyclines don't cause heart attacks. So I've covered a lot about the red devil. You can see why we don't call it that, but you should feel free to. If you've had an anthracycline, doxorubicin in particular, drop a comment or question below. If you're curious about whether this might be part of your treatment plan, don't forget to go to yerbba.com to get your personalized report. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.